Zaga, Zaga. Si Dios que tú vivís, Shaba. Shaba, Shaba.
I start off by prepping my hair, and this is what a typical wash day looks like for me.
Shaba.
Hairfinity sent me their Beneath the Weave hair care line to try out within the last few months, and it has definitely become a staple. I also dig their packaging because you can easily get between your sewings to also nurture your own hair. I shampoo my hair about twice a month or as needed because most of the time my hair is in cornrows anyway. And whenever it is, I usually just cold wash it like once a week. I shampoo whenever it's time to take down and redo the braids. And this shampoo is pretty cleansing, so I wouldn't advise using it too often unless your hair is really dirty. It has this minty refreshing feel to it as well, and I'm guessing it's because of the peppermint oil in it, which helps stimulate hair growth. Depending on the state of my hair, I'll follow up with just the regular conditioner, and I like the consistency because it's perfect for cold washing as well. Whenever my hair needs some extra care, maybe it's feeling weak or drier than normal, then I'd opt for the straightening mask instead, which usually happens about once a month. I wouldn't recommend using this too often either because it's protein based, and too much protein for the hair is not good either, especially if your hair is protein sensitive. I let it sit in my hair for hours and hours because I want it to really penetrate, so I use that time to make me a wig.
AMG baby, Bumi D, Mami, MDK, Swag, Poof, Zaga, although you be one in a pretty.
I wanted to color the wig a subtle brown shade, but didn't want to go through the hassle of bleaching and all that, so I used just the 40 volume developer method I learned from Fabulosity's Me years ago, like when YouTube used to be a bit more fun. But yeah, this is also less damaging to the hair, so I saturated the hair with the developer and let it process overnight. I went off the rinse off my own hair and added the leave-in conditioner while it's still damp. And this is my favorite product out of the whole line because it leaves my hair so soft. Then I seal my hair with their nourishing oil, which I like because it doesn't feel too greasy and it's full of different kinds of essential oils. And it smells pretty nice as well. Actually, all these products have really nice scents to them. They're not too overpowering either. I would normally let my hair air dry, but at this point, I was extremely tired and about ready to go to sleep. So I blow dried it and went to sleep. The following morning, I went off to wash and condition the wig, and while it's drying, I added some straight back cornrows to my own hair. As usual, I added the elastic band to help my wig stay down, fit it to my head, and I used the styling foam to help mold the little hairs in the front to help camouflage the lace a little bit better. I tied it down for some minutes, then sprayed the hair down with the water and conditioner mixture that I made to add some moisture and definition. Now onto the makeup. It's very simple look today. I primed my face with the Smashbox primer water, followed up with my ABH stick foundation, and I couldn't find my typical chestnut shade, so I managed the cocoa, which is a bit darker, but don't worry, everything will fall into place by the end of this video, trust me. And I highlighted with the Kat Von D concealer. I actually OD'd a bit on the Sasha powder to set because I typically don't bake, I just use enough to set, so I followed up with my regular face powder to dust off the excess. Eyebrows, fill them in with a dark brown pencil and clean them up with the concealer. Finished up with a darker powder to contour a little bit and slapped on the glow. The best part. I added a dash of color to my lids with the darker powder as well, blend out my nose glow, and seal everything with my setting spray. Lips are pretty basic, liner, lip color, then gloss it up. I'm using my simplest lashes today as well to make my face pop a little bit more. I tweeze the hair a little bit to add more volume and make the curls look a bit less perfect and, you know, a little effortless. Like, I didn't really put that much effort. And that is all for this video. Thank you all so much for watching. I'll leave all links and details to items you might need or want to know in the info section down below. She say life is a drug, she lost in the world. You was the wifey material, you was the one in a million, girl. I was still planning to get